Hello and welcome to the shyu channel, where I listen to music I've never heard before. I'm excited to finally dive into the solo works of the Boy Genius members, other than Phoebe Bridges, which we did already. And we're starting off with Julien Baker's Sprained Ankle debut album, which was released in late 2016. So yeah, no long talking, we're gonna go straight into track one, Blacktop. Okay, blacktop is the American word for tarmac or road surface. Oh, that's nice. The way she broke down the street word. Interesting. That was track one. Beautiful voice, man. Like I said in my last Boy Genius album reaction, Julien had my favorite voice out of the three. And the Satanist song, which I love, she apparently wrote the lyrics for the other members for that song. And so I presumed that she was maybe nihilistic, but from this song, she's actually a Christian. And I love the metaphors throughout here and the like very empty beat with just like the guitar. She's talking to God. I believe she got in a car crash and she says, "I saw your hand when I went out and wrapped my car," which is meaning God putting out his hand to save her. And the love letters are songs of God. Come visit me in the back of an ambulance. The devil in my arms says, "Feed me to the wolves tonight." One interpretation is self-harming. Another is drugs, but whichever it is, she's asking God to visit her in the back of an ambulance to give her another chance at life, I guess. Pretty deep song. We're going to go into, wait, who produced that one? Michael Hegner or Hainer, and the same producer on this track. So maybe he produced all the tracks, we'll see. So that was Blacktop, nice little intro. We're going to go into track two, Sprained Ankle, the title track. I like that. Wish I could write songs about anything other than death. Oh, this one's super smooth. Interesting lyrics in this one, and I love the instrumentation a lot more in this compared to the first song. It's super soothing. Okay, I love that song sonically, and the lyrics again super strong here. So starts off with a very interesting line: "Wish I could write songs about anything other than death." So she's kind of admitting that she's pessimistic and she doesn't want to be anymore, I guess. Okay, so she has former substance use. "Can't go to bed without drawing the red," which refers to cherry of the cigarette, apparently. Shaving off breath could be shortening lifespan. That's super, that's clever. So, spilling my guts, sweat on a microphone, breaking my voice. I would imagine that's her describing herself on stage. But then she says, "Whenever I'm alone with you, can't talk, but isn't the weather nice? Are you okay? A sprinter learning to wait. Maybe someone who's rushing into things instead of analyzing and then going into something. So we are learning a little bit about her as a person, which is nice. It's quite an introspective, personal project so far, which is great. And debut albums tend to be like that. a lot of the time, because it's your first foot in the door into the industry, right? And you're not fully in the music business yet, so a lot of the lyrics are a bit more about your life and not the obscurities of the music industry, etc. And it's a bit more pure, especially if you're independent artist, which most are for their debut albums, right? I would imagine, unless they have a huge single. But yeah, I really like that song. Okay, let's go into track 3, Brittle Boned, which is actually pretty similar to the previous title and the title of the album. I love that. Static snows. So this is probably a concept album. I mean, like a very cohesive story kind of thing. Same sentiment throughout. She's in the hospital now. She mentioned the ambulance earlier. Oh, I could just imagine it. Like the thoughts going through your head when you're in the ambulance after substance abuse. You're starting to regret your decisions. And that's when, I guess, God feels the closest to you. And that's where you're hoping God puts his hand out and saves you. I don't think I've heard an album where... I don't know if she'll continue it, but from the ambulance to the hospital, like, naming the places where they are, and throughout the songs you could picture them through this journey. I feel like that would be super cool if a whole album was like that, a story where the points of interest are putting the puzzle together, because you can actually picture where they are. Oh wow, now that is a really cool set of lines here. This song completely captures that that moment between life and death, pretty much. That's what I'm getting from it. Super cool. Brittle boned, where you're most vulnerable. Super weak, bunch of regrets. Feeling faint in the hospital, not knowing if you're gonna make it. Asking God for help. The static snow, I love that. The whirring machines, the waiting rooms can't hide me. Paper sheets, blood work, and the IV. Yeah, amazing. White flag, blindfold covering my sunken eyes, which is probably like when you're super close to death and you kind of metaphorically died. So it alludes to the killing of parts of a personality or past that is no longer wanted. Okay. Ah, death sentence for the past. Oh, that's cool. Ooh, okay. So it's kind of killing her old self that she hates, I guess. Maybe between that life and death moment, if it's literal and also metaphorical, because she did get in a car crash, right? And she got to the hospital, and then she has those thoughts, but it's also killing her old self. It's sort of like, if I make it through this, I'm never doing the shit that I was doing before. That got me in this place. Driving under the influence, right? I'm guessing. I don't think it mentioned that, but definitely mentioned drug abuse and a car crash. Super cool concept so far. I like how easy it is to follow and how empty the instrumentation is. So it really highlights the lyrics. Okay, track 4, Everybody Does. Backing vocals. Ooh, wait, this can mean a lot of different things, this whole thing. So she's either talking to her new reformed self or to a partner or like a friend. potential partner, potential friend. Wow. I love those last repeating lines. It's like she's just expecting everyone to figure out the troubles that she's had and judge her for it, and then just disappear and leave the relationship that they have. Because I'm kind of following the story closely here, kind of like the ambulance, the point between life and death, asking God for help. This could almost be her breaking through, making it through that struggle, and reforming. And then she's actually kind of talking to her reformed self, telling herself that, oh, you're just going to go back to the filthy wreckage. But it's probably just talking to someone, but I just thought it was pretty cool that it's a possibility that it could be that. Because it's kind of cool, you're going to run right back to the drugs. But it's probably not that, but I just thought that was kind of cool. Okay, let's go into track 5, Good News. Ooh, like Mac Miller. Ooh. Wait, I just realized maybe it's also talking to God in the previous track, saying, you're gonna run, everybody does. Ooh, that'll also be kind of cool. I wonder if she's talking about God here. Lovely. You know what? I really like music that is heavy on metaphors, because it leaves it up to the listener to decide what it means, right? And I really like the idea of personifying God. Like with this line, it's not easy when what you think of me is important. And I know it shouldn't be so damn important, but it is to me. I'm gonna believe that she's talking to God, because I will enjoy it more if it is. I mean, that's what I would think anyways, if I just ignore annotations and stuff, which is how it's meant to be consumed, right? It does say an annotation for this first line that is possibly referring to Jesus because of the long hair. Okay, let's get into track 6, Something. Backwards in like a lap. I love the echo on the vocals right now. It's a light echo, but it adds so much. So this seems like she's actually talking about a person here. It's kind of hard to imagine this is God in this one. Mostly because she says, I know you're sleeping by now. Oh, I like that. That line's really cool. So in this song, she feels kind of empty and kind of chasing the love of someone. Kind of left alone, like the first couple lines. I know you're sleeping by now, but I'm still up walking around. Really like a lonely situation, or like thought to have. And that's why she was waiting for the pavement or the it was pavement twice. Yeah, it's like she's waiting for the pavement to answer because there's no one left. She thought she meant something to this person, but she meant nothing to that person. sat and watched you drive away, which kind of plays off of the I'm chasing your tail lights. Well, here she was chasing, here she's just sitting down and watching them drive away. Yeah, that was a nice song. Now it's, that song was very much about an actual person, and I can't personify God into that one. So yeah, bit of a change. Let's get into track 7, Rejoice. This riff sounds familiar. More kind of lonely situations. Sleep on a bench in the park on my birthday. It's probably my favorite guitar riff so far. I wonder if that's withdrawal symptoms. Yeah. Interesting. Strong vocals here. She really projected her voice a lot more in this track, because there's so much passion in rejoicing, a very genuine rejoice. I wondered what this meant. All of my friends live in a plastic bag. I thought it was drugs, because it kind of plays off of the last song, where she had some lonely thoughts just seeing the person she thought she meant something to just drive away. She feels like she means nothing to anyone. And here she says, sleep on a bench in the park on my birthday. Kind of the same sentiment. So I thought of this as drugs. All my friends are drugs. She mentions some withdrawal symptoms here. I wish I could quit, but I can't stand the shakes. And then it goes into admitting she still believes, she does believe there is a God and that she was made by a creator. Even though she's doing all these sinister things, but she's still rejoicing the fact that there is a God. And maybe that's her sense of hope, that it won't always be like this. Yeah, really powerful song, man. Okay, we're gonna go into track 8, Vessels. One of the longer tracks on the album, but it hasn't got many lyrics, surprisingly. To do that. Oh, I love that line. If that's referencing God and this is referencing the Bible, that is beautiful, the way she worded this. Yeah, so the black is like her sinfulness, and the white clothes are the purity of her beliefs. And that's what she's clinging on to, those clothes. And it's still attached to her, like clothes. And clothes also cover up skin, so it's kind of, she's covering up her sinful past with her beliefs. 2 minutes gone already. This did not feel like that went by fast. The armor could also be referring to the white clothes. He's talking to God directly here again, I believe. I don't know Bible verses, so if she's directly referencing those, I wouldn't be able to pick it up. But it did mention one here on this annotation. Love the metaphors throughout this one. And how she's like embracing her faith, prioritizing it since she's covering up the black ink. Okay, we're gonna go straight into the final track, track 9, Go Home. Wow.
The
That's some imagery right there. Oh, I love that. I don't think this is about an actual person. I think it's God again saying, lock all the cabinets and send me to bed. More so kind of not physically lock the cabinets, but take over my mind in a sense to bring me to the thoughts of not going anywhere near the cabinets and to just go to sleep. Like, direct me on that path. Yeah, I love that line, man. I love that. I'm tired of washing my hands. And I know my body is just dirty clothes. I'm tired of washing my hands. I love that line. Amazing. See, even though I'm not a believer, I don't think there is a creator. I love seeing these really beneficial sides to being religious. Because it places importance on being, I guess, sensible, especially in terms of drug abuse. If religion and prayer really gave almost a placebo effect to someone to not go near the drugs again, then surely it can't be a bad thing to be religious in that sense then, right? I think that's beautiful. So at the end, she's playing In Christ Alone. It sounds familiar. It's a Christian song. That's a really nice way to end it too. Okay. That was Sprained Ankle by Julien Baker. I really enjoyed the very clear-cut concept. How personal it is, how we basically went through her whole story of how she overcame drug abuse, which I'm imagining she did overcome it, right? Actually, the metaphors really made this an amazing project. The use of metaphors in her poetry is insane. I feel like you could do tens and tens of different annotations for some lines. And yeah, I don't know if I would revisit any of the songs, but as a full album listen, it's like how you're meant to listen to it. I believe I can't really pick out a song and listen to it. There was one, I can't see now, it's kind of like a blur, I can't pick out which one it was, but I think there was one. Actually, Sprained Ankle, the title track, is one that I possibly would go back to. But yeah, very intimate kind of experience, probably a very therapeutic experience for her to write this and create this album, and it was great. I'm still on the journey of the Boy Genius albums, and I'm probably doing Lucy next, but the only thing is I will start with her first project actually. Someone did mention to start from Historian, but I'm gonna do No Burden first. I figured it would just make sense. But yeah, happy I finally got around to doing this. Hope you enjoyed. If you enjoyed, please like, comment, subscribe, and leave any suggestions down below as well. Yeah, see you in the next video. Peace.